Hey everyone, I'm Justin, and today I'm going to be using exponents to help me with a little experiment I have going on. And by the end of this lesson, you'll be able to explain the connection between exponents and repeated multiplication. Let's get into it. So, for my experiment, I've been observing some amazing bacteria that double in quantity every hour. Here's what they looked like when I started. Aren't they cool? Each time I observe the bacteria, I've been adding data to a chart that helps me visualize the bacteria's growth. At 1 p.m., I started with 2 bacteria. At 2 p.m., I had 2 times 2, or 4 bacteria. It's now almost 3 p.m., so let's see what happened. Wow! The 4 bacteria have doubled to 8 bacteria. So at 3 p.m., I now have 2 times 2 times 2, or 8 bacteria. Science is amazing. 7 hours later. Okay, I'm up. Whew, just in time, it's 10 p.m. Pause the video here and make a prediction by completing the rest of the multiples column in your activity chart. All right, let's see how many bacteria we have now. Oh, that's a lot of bacteria! Way too many to count. Luckily, I have my handy chart, and I can use math to find out the exact answer. Remember, the bacteria doubles every hour, and it's been 10 hours. That means we have 2 times 2 times 2 times 2... Well, this is getting a little out of hand. Let me just show you instead. The total is now 1,024 bacteria. Okay, I've updated my chart with the new information. If the bacteria keeps growing at this rate, I'm gonna run out of room with all of these twos. There has to be a better way to keep track of all those values. I have an idea. I know that when I want to add the same number over and over again, I can use multiplication as a sort of shorthand notation. Multiplication is just repeated addition. So instead of writing 2 plus 2 plus 2, we could just write 3 times 2 to represent the same thing. Writing it that way is much more compact. For repeated multiplication, there is a similar shorthand notation called exponential notation. Let's take a look at the multiples in the 4th row in the chart, where we are multiplying 2 by itself 4 times. We can write that number using exponential notation. A number in exponential notation always has 2 parts, the base and the exponent. The base is the number that gets multiplied in an exponential statement. So, which number are we trying to multiply by itself here? That's right, 2. The exponent is the number of times we are multiplying the base by itself. So how many times are we multiplying 2 by itself? That's right, 4. We write the exponent smaller above the 2, almost like it's in a corner. This whole expression is now read as 2 to the 4th power. Now we can replace the multiples column with our exponential representation. Ugh, that looks much better. Let's see how we can use this on the last row in our chart. So by 10 o'clock, we had to write out a lot of twos. So how do you think we could write 2 multiplied by itself 10 times in exponential notation? That's right, as 2 to the 10th power, which is the base and which is the exponent. Exactly. The base is 2 and the exponent is 10. Here is our new, fully updated chart using exponential notation. Exponents have been a big help for representing the growth of our bacteria. However, sometimes we want to work backwards and represent our exponential statement as repeated multiplication. Let's take a look at another exponential notation example. What do you think 5 to the third power means? Just as we did before, the first step is to identify the base and the exponent. In this case, the 5 is the base. This is the number that will be repeatedly multiplying by itself. Then we notice that the exponent is 3. So we'll multiply 5 by itself 3 times. How do you think we'll write this out? Yes, 5 times 5 times 5. This is known as the expanded form of 5 to the third power. So, as we've shown, exponents are a great way to represent repeated multiplication in a compact way. So, if we have something like this, we can replace it with this. Remember that the base is the number we want to multiply by itself, and the exponent is the number of times we want to multiply that number. In this exponential statement, which is the base and which is the exponent? Yep, that's right. The 4 is the base and the 5 is the exponent. It's also super easy to do the reverse and write the number in expanded form. We just write the base as many times as the exponent tells us to with a multiplication sign in between each one. So if we started with 8 to the third power, we could expand that to 8 times 8 times 8. Writing numbers in exponential form could be a huge time saver. But what other numbers can we use with exponents? And are there any special exponents that we can use? How can we evaluate exponents? Well, be sure to check out our next lesson to find out. See you next time! Hey.